such a diverse, vibrant city. You know, you may be from here and not realize it, but how does growing up in such a city influence your work, and how does that pour into what you put down in the studio on the paper when you put this all together?
Okay, I'm going to tell everybody right now, first off, I'm a New Yorker. Doesn't matter what borough, none of that, I really could care less. It's in my blood, New York. Everything I say, the way I dress, my attitude, you know off the top, I'm from New York. There's no hiding that. So how does it translate into my music? You can hear it, the aggression, the cockiness. You know, it's a lot of traits that New Yorkers have that is evident if you really pay attention. The thing is, though, I want to say something real quick. One thing I do feel about New York, our diversity is also strength, and I also feel it's a weakness. I feel that because there are a lot of different entities in New York, and many people are doing different things. I feel like a lot of times it separates us, you know, and many people, they don't understand the power of unification. And that's why certain counties or areas such as like the South, California, you know, I think they have strong movements, the Bay Area. When you look at those artists, they don't say, I'm from the east side of the Bay Area, I'm from whatever, you know, this and the third. They usually have a unified movement. And I think that that's what makes them strong. New York, on the other hand, it's like a crab in a bucket mentality here. And a lot of people, they don't want to see you come up because they're doing something different, or they're from a different region of New York, and we don't work together, you know? But I feel that that's, like I said again, it's one of our weaknesses. But me personally, I tend to lead by example. So, you know, I'm going to work with a lot of up-and-coming artists. I'm going to work with, you know, the established ones. I'm going to work with everybody. And like I said, I'm not repping one borough. I'm repping New York till I D-I-E. So you already know what it is. That's that. That's that.
Word. When did Donnie Goins realize that hip-hop in this form of expression is the way for you to go?
January 2006. Basically, the way I realized this was that, you know, I was working a regular 9-to-5. I was in Westchester, New York. And I wasn't really doing anything. You know, to me, it was just kind of like going through the motions. I was basically, you know, doing a 9-to-5, just going to work, coming back home. Nothing really special. And then one day out of like sheer boredom, I happened to go to Circuit City to like just go buy a couple movies to watch. And one of the movies that I picked up was the movie Fade to Black. And, you know, I didn't really think none of it at first. I just put it in, watched it. And upon watching it, you know, I was like, it was like an epiphany to me. Like, I just felt like, wow, you know, if this man could ascend to those heights based on the strength of hip-hop, I was like, this is something I have to do. And the thing is that I've always dabbled in music beforehand. It's not like I just woke up and like, I'm gonna be a rapper all of a sudden. But it was like an epiphany. That's the only way to describe it to me, it was like something that just awoke within me. And once that happened, you know, I wrote a song called Inspiration that very night. And from that point on, I said, I'm not turning back. And I just went full steam ahead. And it's been that way ever since.
Okay. What is your inspiration outside of music? What are some of the things you want to do? It doesn't have to be a clothing line, but what are some things that you want to...
Every rapper got a clothing line, right? Wait, real quick, I want to say shout out to Jeezy, as a matter of fact, you know, wearing some of his joy right now. And shout out to Shady, I got some of his pants on right now. I love y'all.
I'm sorry. Yeah, what is your inspiration? Where do you put your, when you say you're working on your influence, when you become more influential, what is going to be the result of having that type of influence, having that type of power as an artist?
Good question. I'm not going to give any definite answers because I don't know where this path is going to take me directly. So I don't want to say like, okay, I'm going to do this in X amount of years and X amount of time and it's going to execute it. No. What I am going to say is, as I get more power and more influence, I'm going to use it in a more positive manner. Because I feel that that's the biggest problem within a lot of artists in this realm, music. A lot of artists, they make a lot of money, and what they tend to focus on a lot is like the women, you know, the bikinis and Bentleys and bling and, you know, many other bees that go along with that. But the problem is, you know, children, they see these videos and they read these interviews, and I think they end up being blinded and they become jaded, you know, and they look at life from a perspective that's not really realistic. You know, I come from the have-nots. I come from the welfare lines. I come from the struggle. And when I come up, it's only right to give back. How I'm going to give back, I can't say for sure. But I know that I'm going to give back, and I know that I'm going to try my best to be a positive influence to other people out there. You know, if you listen to a lot of my music, you'll notice that I don't really focus a lot on the negativity. You know, I focus more on, like, you know, the positive and the upcoming and things that strengthen people and make them feel good. You know, of course, it's not sugar-coated music by any means whatsoever. There's a lot of vulgarities in my rhymes. There's a lot of, you know, real-life issues. But again, these are things that happen in real life. But I don't want to be like the typical artist. Like, a clothing line, like, you know what I'm saying? No disrespect to anyone who has a clothing line, but that's not something that's in my agenda. I mean, you know, if it happened, it happened, but that's not really my main thing. You know, money isn't even really my main focus, to be quite honest. A lot of people be like, you know, you're crazy. But I've turned down a lot of deals already. You know, I've basically, because the money is not the end all to me. You know, I look at things like, what do I want to leave behind when I finish this? And I want to leave behind a legacy. And I don't want it to be a negative legacy. I want it to be a positive legacy. And I want people to say about me, like, yo, you know, that kid, you know, he inspired me to do something positive. He inspired me to follow my career. He inspired me to go to school. He inspired, because not everybody needs to be a rapper, you know? Come on. It's just like I said, I want to do positive things. And, like, however them, those kind of feelings manifest into the future, that's yet to be seen. But they will come to fruition in the near future. Okay. That's a good question. I'm gonna really think before I answer this one. You know, many people inspire me with their legacies. You know, I listen to various documentaries. I watch documentaries. I listen to various people speak. I read a lot. I'm very well versed in a lot of different things. So, you know, I'm inspired by people like, you know, Gandhi, for example. He says things like, you know, you must be the change which you wish to see in the world. You know, that's inspiring. And if you really think about it, it makes a lot of sense. And basically, what it means to me is that, do it. Like, do what you want to see. Like, if you want the world to be, you know, a cleaner planet, I'll give you a good example. Look at this water I'm drinking right now, right? A lot of people don't know that plastic is really, you know, messing up, you know, the ecosystem. You know, I'm not very well versed in it, but I do know a little bit about it to speak on it. Now, this bottle right here is designed with less plastic. It's 30% less plastic. Buying this bottle alone helps you with, you know, preserve the environment. You know, and it might be small. You might be like, wow, like, that's what the fuck? He's buying a water bottle. But you got to think about it. Every little bit helps. So, you know, I just go about various things. I can't just say it's one person. Donald Goins is another one. You know, like, to be quite honest, and for all those watching, this might seem a shock to you, but Donald Goins isn't my favorite author. You know what I mean? I'm just going to be for real about that because I'm the kind of person I am. Actually, James Patterson is my favorite author. But, you know, Donald Goins is a great author, and he laid the blueprint for all those novels that you see in the street right now. Think about that. You know, you have, like, I mean, what are some of the popular, like, Terry Woods, I believe her name is, you know, and a lot of other novels that are out there now, the street novels, he made those. That's the blueprint, you know what I mean? And I just translate that into music. There's so many people. I could sit here for days naming names, but the thing is, I take inspiration from everyone and everything around me, and I try to be positive, again, however I can be. And that's basically what it is. As far as my legacy is concerned, that's yet to be known. I mean, I might turn around, I might wake up tomorrow, and I might be like, you know what? I need to be an advocate for this situation right here. You know, I give you one situation in New York. You know, being that this is a worldwide platform, I'm going to bring y'all in, excuse me, my world, Sean Bell issue. You know, that's an issue in New York that's heavy right now. You know, a lot of people who don't know, Sean Bell was a man who was killed on the eve of his wedding day. You know, he was celebrating his bachelor party, and the cops basically killed him and used excessive force. They shot him over 50 times. And the sad part about it is that the police that used excessive force actually got away. They, no charges. They walked away unscathed. And the thing is, this is not the first time this happened, but it won't be the last either. And I'll be honest, like, I made a song recently called Killer Pig behind that song, you know? And it's like, don't let the name fool you. It's very intelligent. You have to listen to the words. But the thing is that I don't understand, like, how people like that get away with crimes in our community. And it's like, I felt compelled to speak on it, you know? So who knows what tomorrow brings? Something might happen, and I might be like, you know what? I have to put my energy into this right here. I have to do this. I have to do that. Because at the end of the day, sitting here talking about things is not it. You have to be active. You have to be proactive, and you have to do things. Talking is just talking.